Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship. It is so good to see you here today, both in person and online. We have an exciting morning planned for you with a children's musical and worship, and I just think it'll be a special time to reconnect with each other and with our Savior through this time of worship. My name is Scott Beard. I'm the lead pastor here, and I'm so excited to spend this morning with you.
It is a beautiful day to be in worship together, however you are joining us. My name is Jennifer Finley, our Momentum and Discipleship Pastor here, and we are grateful to be joining together in worship. A couple of notes as we worship together, especially for those who might not join us each week. Our worship is guided by our bulletins, either online or what you received as you came in. That will have our responses for our worship time, as well as our hymns are in your hymnals or on the screen or in the online bulletin. It is going to be a joy to have our children leading us in worship this morning. One note about Holy Communion. We celebrate Holy Communion each week here, and all are welcome, whether you have been here once or whether this is your first time. If you are seeking to know Jesus Christ, you are welcome to join us. For those online, we invite you to have crackers or grapes or juice or something to eat or drink for that point in the worship service. For those here in this space, we're going to do something a little bit different today, and I know change is hard, but I also know we can do this. So for those who are here in this space, we are going to be exiting our pews, going towards the windows, and we'll be serving you at the end of the pew and asking you to exit down the side aisle and come back to your seats via the center aisle. We have done that before, but it's been a few years. For those in the balcony, we will have a communion station upstairs to serve you as well. And we'll have a little bit of beautiful holy chaos, and it will be lovely and wonderful. A couple of quick announcements as you look at your bulletins. Note that there are all kinds of things coming up in the life of our faith community that we would love for you to be a part of as our Advent journey continues, as well as we head into Christmas Eve and Christmas Day and New Year's Day worship services. Those times are all in your bulletin. And it is a time when we think about giving back to others. And so we are collecting gloves, new gloves for our clothing closet to distribute. That's our shared ministry with the Presbyterian Church across the street. There's a donation box out in the Northix, the gathering area, and we invite you to bring those by next Sunday, and we will get those to the right spot. And now, as we settle into a time of worship, we invite our Advent candle lighters to come forward this morning.
It's a bit of a maze to get up here today, so hopefully you...
First. We believe in a God who has been loving, inviting, transforming, and challenging us from generation to generation. And we believe that same God is with us now, calling us towards joy.
Think for a moment, what brings you joy?
Be careful. Step down. You can step down.
Today we are gathered around the candles of hope.
Good job.
Peace. And joy. May their light remind us of all the good news this season brings.
May the light remind us of the many sources of joy in our lives, and may that joy not only draw us closer to one another, but closer to God. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Thank you all for your.
And as each week we light our Advent candles, we've been asking that question, what brings you peace? What brings you hope? What brings you joy? And we invite you to respond to that question either in the comments online, what brings you joy? Or if you are here in this space, there's some note cards in your pews or out in the gathering space, and we invite you to simply jot a note. What brings you joy? And help us create a bulletin board full of hope and peace and joy. And now, as you are able, we invite you to stand in body or spirit as we join together in our call to worship. God is drawing us together this day.
Our spirits rejoice as we journey together.
God is drawing us toward hope this day.
Our spirits rejoice as we journey together.
God is drawing us toward peace this day.
Our spirits rejoice as we journey together.
God is drawing us toward joy this day.
Our spirits rejoice as we journey together.
We are drawn into the heart of God this day.
Our spirits rejoice as we journey together.
Come, let us worship.
Please remain standing and take your hymnals. Turn to number 234. We'll sing together, O Come All Ye Faithful, verses 1, 2, and 3. Let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. True God, light from light eternal, Lord. Not the virgin's womb. Son of the Father, begotten, not created. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Sing choirs of angels, sing in exultation. Oh, sing, all ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, all glory in the highest. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Please remain standing for affirmation of faith. You'll find on your bulletin or on the screen. Let's read this together. We are not alone.
We live in God's world.
We believe in God who has created and is creating. Who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, to reconcile and make new. Who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God.
We are called to be the church.
To celebrate God's presence.
To love and to serve others.
To seek justice and resist evil.
To proclaim Jesus crucified and risen.
Our judge and our hope.
In life and death, and life beyond death.
God is with us.
We are not alone.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
You may be seated.
Amen and amen. Come to the time in our worship service where we share together our joys and our concerns, where we come before God, acknowledging all of the things that are part of our lives. And as we do each week, as part of our prayer time, we light the candle. And some candles have already been lit here in this space, and if you are worshiping at home, we invite you to have a candle with you, to acknowledge those ways in which the Holy Spirit prays with us and intercedes on our behalf. When perhaps we don't have the words, we know that we come with many joys this morning, our children leading us in worship being prime among them. But we also know that our world is complicated and we come with many burdens on our hearts as well. This morning we are in prayer with the congregation of Macon United Methodist Church just south of us as their pastor, Reverend Eric Moore, passed away earlier this week unexpectedly. And so we are continuing to hold them and Eric's family and friends and colleagues in prayer today as the visitation happens this afternoon and a funeral service tomorrow. We know that there are many things in our hearts, and we invite you into a time of prayer, into a time of silence, to acknowledge those with God and each other. And we will have a response in our prayer time. Our response is, Lord, come be with us. Let us pray. God of love and light, we gather from many different experiences of this week, some with shouts of joy, others marked with wounds and grief too deep for words. We pray with shouts and sighs and silence as you gather us all into your heart today. We pray for ourselves, O Lord, that as we settle into these moments of stillness, you meet us here with whatever we might need. Lord, come be with us. We pray for those in our community, for those sitting next to us whose struggles we do not know, for those we worship with who we cannot see. We pray for each other, Lord, that you come into our midst, that you mold and shape us. Lord, come be with us. We pray for all of creation, O Lord, that you created out of overflowing love and joy, for the ways in which that love is hidden by human failings. We pray, Lord, come be with us. For all that is not as you would have it to be, we pray, Lord, come be with us. God of love, give us a vision to delight together in what you have created. Give us a vision of deep joy. Lord, come be with us. Come be with us, O Lord. Shape us and form us through your love, that we may shape and form a world that reflects you. Amen.
Amen. You may remain in your seat for this hymn. It's number 211 in your red hymnal. We'll sing the first four verses of O Come, Emmanuel.
O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel that mourns in lowly exile here, until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou wisdom from on high, and order all things far and nigh. To us the path of knowledge show, and cause us in our ways to go. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, great Lord of might, who to thy tribes on Sinai's height in ancient times once gave the law. In cloud and majesty and awe, rejoice, rejoice, Christ, Emmanuel, shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou root of Jesse's tree, an ensign of thy people be. Before thee rulers silent fall, all peoples on thy mercy call. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
As they are finishing setting up, I will introduce our group.
Can I steal your microphone?
Okay. One of my favorite verses is Matthew chapter 19, verse 14, where Jesus says, "Let the little children come to me. Do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these." These little children have been working very hard to deliver the message to you today, and I hope that you enjoy as they explain to you, to some very confused friends who think that the birth of Jesus is only about shepherds and angels, and they let you know the celebration that the birth of Christ truly is. So enjoy our beautiful musical.
Welcome to the worship. The children's choir is here to celebrate the birthday of Jesus.
Celebrate? Birthday? And I thought this was just a concert. Are we going to have a party?
You betcha. That's what Christmas is. A birthday party for Jesus.
Oh, I love parties. And look at all the people that came.
I know. It looks like our first group is dressed for a party.
Maybe a costume party. It's Christmas, for crying out loud. Shouldn't they be wearing bathrobes and holding shepherd's staffs?
What? Yeah, we'll get to that later. All right, choir, let's get going. It's time to celebrate.
Little kids and bigger kids and all in between. Join us with the angel chorus. I've never seen anything quite like it. Quite like that. Why are they wearing them anyway?
Well, that song is old-time rock and roll, like in the 1950s.
Yeah, my grandma told me about the 1950s. Girls used to wear poodle skirts.
Why?
I have no idea. But I have some Hello Kitty pajamas.
I think we're supposed to be introducing the next song, not talking about our pajamas.
Yeah, we didn't come here to have a sock off.
Now I'm really confused. Why do you keep talking about skirts and pajamas and socks? And where are the shepherds and wise men?
And the angels. I usually play a part of an angel.
We'll get to that later. Be right. We're supposed to be telling people about the birth of Jesus. It reminds me of the prophet Isaiah, who told about the birth of Jesus hundreds of years before he was born. Listen to this verse.
For a child will be born for us, a son will be given to us. He will be named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6.
The dominion will be vast and its prosperity will never end. He will reign on the throne of David and over his kingdom to establish and sustain it with justice and righteousness from now on and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will accomplish this. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 7.
Now that's what I'm talking about, armies and kingdoms, and I know God likes to make things happen.
And he wants us to tell others about all the things that he does. The choir has some good news.
Savior Jesus.
Olive, the song's over.
But I love it.
You love everything. The costumes, the songs, the dancing.
Well, it is a party.
Well, you're right. And we need to make sure that all these people know the real reason for Christmas and why we are so happy.
You know, the baby who was born in the manger grew up to be the savior of the world. Makes me want to sing and worship him.
Did you know the first people to worship Jesus were a bunch of raggedy shepherds?
Finally, shepherds. It all started right outside Bethlehem. This is how it went down. There were these shepherds just hanging out with their sheep. Then they saw a bright star in the sky no one could explain. All of a sudden, you could see angels singing praises.
Ooh, angels are my specialty. Wait, I forgot exactly what they sang.
It was First Noel.
Huh?
And Noel is a Christmas carol.
So they could meet Jesus.
That's right.
See, told you we need shepherds.
I just remembered. Earlier the choir sang Gloria in Excelsis Deo. It sounds so important.
Angels must sing in Latin. It translates to glory to God in the highest.
Oh wow, that's awesome. I know that I'm God's favorite.
Really? How would you know that? Actually, we're all God's favorites. Listen to this.
You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a God's own possession. You have become his people so that you may speak of the wonderful acts of the one who called you out of the darkness and into the light. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9.
See, I knew it. We need to praise God for loving us all like that.
God loves to hear us praise him and sing with all our hearts.
I think we all should sing praises to God right now.
Even the audience?
Even the audience.
Okay, joy to the world. Let heaven and nature sing. Stand and sing with us.
Thank you.
I really like the part of the song that says Christ the Savior is born.
Me too. Jesus left his throne in heaven to be near us.
Sometimes I can't believe he would do that. Heaven is like perfect.
Okay. Isaiah chapter 60 verse 1 says, Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord shines over you. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Anyone who follows me will never walk in the darkness, but will have the light of life. John chapter 8 verse 12.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. old.
Are we supposed to take all stuff off?
There is absolutely nothing better than being led to the good news by our children. Absolutely nothing better. And as we have heard that good news proclaim that the light has come, we are called to respond to that, each in our own ways. But one of the ways in which we respond together in worship is by gathering at the table of Holy Communion, a table that is big and wide and bigger than we could possibly ever imagine. And so you are invited today as an act of praise and worship, as an active response to our children, to receive communion this morning together. And as we mentioned earlier, for those who are online, we'll invite you to partake as part of our service. For those who are here in this space, we will here in a few moments invite you to leave your pews going this direction, and we will be serving you at the end of the pews and coming back around. And those in the balcony will serve up there as well. And if you need to be served in your seats, Teresa will have our tray to do that as well.
Well, as we prepare our hearts and minds for this this communion celebration, this remembrance of what God did for each of us, we certainly are reminded through the beauty of our children and the message that they had about the light. And that's the light that we are called to bring into the world as well. But as we prepare for that, we have a prayer of confession that we'll put on the screen or in your bulletin. And let's read this together. Gracious God, we confess that our hope for a transformed world often dims. Thank you for drawing near in these moments and drawing us into your story of your love over and over again. In this silence, open us anew to the power of your incarnation. Hear this good news. The love of Jesus Christ is at work today, in us, around us, and through us. Thanks be to God.
Amen and amen. And now, as forgiven and reconciled people of Jesus Christ, we invite you to share that peace of Christ with each other, perhaps even add the joy of Christ today, whether it's in the comments online or here in this space. We invite you to share signs of joy and peace with each other. The peace and joy of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Peace and Christ
peace
be with
and joy
you.
Of Christ be with you. On that night that Jesus was betrayed, he met in the upper room with his disciples. And they met to celebrate the Passover. They met together to celebrate that which God had done for them throughout the ages, that God had always delivered the people. Whenever they were in captivity or they had turned away, God was always there to welcome them back. And this is something they continue to celebrate today, the Passover. And with the Holy Communion within our tradition is a reminder of that. But it was during that meal that Jesus did something that was completely out of character for him, at least as far as they understood, and took off his outer garment. And he got down on his knees and he washed the feet of his disciples. To show them what it truly means to be a leader, you must first be a servant, be willing to serve others. And that's what we're called to do. And then he stood up and he said, "But I give you a new commandment, to love one another as I have loved you." If we were to follow that commandment, I think we would solve a lot of the problems in this world. But it was during that meal that Jesus took some of the bread and he gave thanks for it and he broke it in two and he said, "This is my body which is broken for you. Whenever you eat this bread, do so in remembrance of me." In a similar way, he takes a cup and he said, "This is the blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the remission of sins. Whenever you eat of this bread or drink of the cup, do so in memory of me."
And so as Christ first lifted that bread long ago, we lift ours today, trusting in the power of the Holy Spirit that brings us together as one body.
As Christ lifted that cup years ago, we lift our individual cups today, both here and those that are worshiping online. We're knowing that the Holy Spirit can bring these all together, that our hearts and minds can be melded into one through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Almighty God, we pray that you pour out your Holy Spirit on these gifts of crackers and juice and whatever is assembled on the altars of those throughout the world, Lord, that are worshiping with us today or in the future. Lord, let us know that the Holy Spirit of Christ comes with these elements into ourselves, that as we go forth from this place, we can carry that light of the world to others, that others may know of your love and your grace and your peace and joy. These things we lift up in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. And now we pause briefly to bless our meal together in one voice. We invite you into the words of the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. And now we feast together. For those who are worshiping online, we invite you to partake now as you hear these words.
The body of Christ broken for you.
Amen.
The blood of Christ shed for you.
Thanks be to God. The body of Christ given for you.
Amen.
The cup of salvation given for you.
Praise God.
we pray this prayer of thanksgiving as a response to God, as a dedication of our lives and our hearts and our minds to God. Let us pray. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us, one body gathered in you. We offer you ourselves now in gratitude and love. All that we are and all that we have come freely from you. Grant now that we may go into our days in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now we stand in body or spirit as we sing together.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all creatures here below. Hallelujah. Source of all our gifts. Praise Jesus Christ, whose power uplifts. Praise the Spirit, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah. We're going to sing a song. It doesn't look like we're confused or anything, does it? Let's sing There's a Song in the Air.
There's a song in the air. There's a star in the sky. There's a mother's deep prayer and a baby's low cry. And the star rains its fire while the beautiful sing for the manger of Bethlehem, cradles a king. There's a tumult of joy for the wonderful birth, for the virgin sweet boy is the Lord of the earth. High the star rains its fire while the beautiful sing for the manger of Bethlehem, cradles a king. In the light of that star by the ages impearled, and that song from afar has swept over the world. Every hearth is aflame and the beautiful sing in the homes of the nations that Jesus is King. We rejoice in the light and we echo the song that comes down through the night from the heavenly throng. Why, we shout to the lovely evangel they bring, and we greet in his cradle our Savior and King.
Amen. And before we conclude, we have a special presentation.
You may be seated for a moment.
Holly Whitaker to come forward for just a moment.
I think it's safe to say that as we raise our families these days, it truly takes a village. And lucky for us, we also have a loving church family. Teresa and Sarah, this morning, the children and their families would like to extend gratitude for your guiding light, your genuine care, and the laughter and fun that you provide our kids. You are another safe place for them in a world that does not always feel secure. Thank you also for the therapeutic conversations that you have with us parents. I surely can't be the only one. And thank you for everything you do for all of our families in all of our walks of faith. Merry Christmas, and thank you both.
Thank you.
Amen. Our staff team wouldn't be complete without Teresa and Sarah. And what a joyous day to worship. And so we invite you to stand if you would like as we go out into the world. For we don't simply stay gathered in the time of worship, but we disperse. And we go with the joy and the reminder of our children that the light is already out there in the world, and we go to reflect it. So go, my friends. Go, whatever this week may hold, knowing that the light is with us.
Let us pray. Oh Lord, I pray a blessing over each and every person here, over the children, over all of those who helped put this message together. Lord, we know that they are reflecting the light of your Son, Jesus Christ, who came into the world that we might understand what it is to have God with us, to guide us and direct us and to comfort us and to give us peace and joy. Lord, I pray a blessing over each of these families as they go into this future and this continued this Christmas season, as we celebrate that light that came into the world through your precious Son, Jesus our Lord, in whose name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Emmanuel.